important in tennis than the physical game, although that's becoming much more important now as well. Would you agree? If yes, how does one best battle one's mental state of mind? How do you get stronger mentally?
I mean, there are a lot of things people do for strengthening of the mind. And even play mental games. You know, people play chess as a way to strengthen their minds. People have conversations with people who are their mentors to be able to encourage them mentally. There are a lot of people who come and do inspirational talks privately and publicly when you have a room of 20 people or when you have a people of 500 people. And you listen to these things that inspire you, something that are able to take you to a different dimension. The greatest thing about mental strength is when you're able to actually have a level of consistency where you take the ordinary and put the extraordinary in it. And there are why things happen and why they take these dimensions, you never know. But then there are certain, all of us have a quality in us that we don't call upon on a normal basis. And I think the great thing about our sport, in tennis especially, is we're able to call upon these things when we least expect it. And you don't think you have it to a great extent till it's called, you're called upon to do it. And it's happened to me on numerous occasions, and you know, you don't think you're capable of doing that. You don't think you're capable of delivering this. For me, it came from my mother. All of it came from my mother. The inspiration that she gave to me, the belief that she had, the extraordinary things that she would do, being even less than ordinary, was just overwhelmingly positive that even if 10% of it got into me, you know, I would be able to ask more of me than I could possibly afford. And that's exactly what happened. So I think mental toughness you can also develop and press on home. Whether it's in life, whether it's in business, whether it's in family, whether it's in sport. Sport is very clear. The greatest thing about our sport is the fact that it's so clear. You win or you lose. There's no draw.
He's not the biggest fan of cricket.
No, I'm a huge fan of cricket. I'm a huge fan of cricket. But, you know, it's kind of hard to see two people playing with 10 people eating sandwiches in the long run. But that's a different story. I'm just saying that the mental aspect of sport is so clear. Yesterday when we saw Federer put his foot down on the pedal in the third set, you know, it was just the clarity of mind of the way this guy was seeing the ball like a football, the tennis court like a football pitch, was just amazed so far in the zone that whatever stroke he hit was in, you know. And then on the other hand was Djokovic having a tough time at the office after the first set, but still being such a great champion that he was able to, you know, delve deep into himself to be able to not let gas game.